I think when fall hits, and especially, you can especially tell with the weather and the leaves on the trees, for most people, that's when everything seems to sort of die down and go to sleep going into winter. But for cross country runner, that's when everything starts to become alive.
I think every runner knows the sensation of being able to breathe again once the temperature comes down, the humidity comes down, the leaves start to change, and you're just like, this is why I do this sport.
In the words of one of my teammates, it's like Christmas. Every runner across the nation can all agree that getting up in odd hours in the morning or running when it's dark out at night to try and beat the heat and humidity is absolutely terrible. So all of a sudden, like, the leaves start changing colors, it gets a little bit crisper, and then it's just like, wow, I can run during the day and not just be absolutely miserable.
When you're in a city, if you're creative about it, literally anywhere is your running option. I could literally run in any direction and find somewhere to go, and there will be something to see, there will be something going on, and I'll get a different kind of run in each instance.
So in Philly, you have the River Trail, which is pretty much 10, 12 miles along the Schuylkill River, uninterrupted running. But then you have John Hines Park, you have the Wissahickon Park, and you have Fairmount Park, where you can go there and get the majority of your runs done on like a soft surface in the trees. If you were to wake up there one morning, you'd have no idea you were in a city.
Fall for one means being together with your team again. We have a pack this year. We have a group of girls that are ready to bring it in, and we need to close that gap and come in strong. We're so cohesive this year, and we really have a pack that's advancing together. So heading into HEPS, I think it's how strong can our pack be?
It's been a big year for a lot of new people to step up, and it's been really exciting to kind of see the whole team build throughout the season. Every week, everyone's getting better. People are stepping up, improving. I think at the last meet, pretty much everyone improved upon their times from last year by at least 30 seconds. So that was huge for the team at large. Just seeing that much improvement, seeing how much better we're getting. And that's just makes everyone excited for HEPS.
So we won the Ivy League Championship last year, and the year before we'd made it to Nationals. So I think the one thing that everybody on our team wants to do this year is put one and one together. We want to not only defend our title and win the Ivy League Championship, but we want to take it one step further and be competitive in our region, hopefully take home a regional title, and then even one step further, going on to Nationals and just kind of proving that, hey, you know, this isn't just somebody else's race. Like, this is our race too, and we're going to go out there and be as competitive as we can.
One thing that we enjoy as part of a team here is we sort of take pride in Philadelphia. We take pride in the other Philly sports, and we sort of consider ourselves, even though we may not have a ton of fans, as one of those Philly sports. Like, I know at practice the other day, we were saying, trust the process. Sometimes when we're on the line at meets, we're like, do it for Philadelphia. So I think having that identity is another cool aspect about our team that you can't find at many other places.